Cooldowns? In ESO?
What?
I keep telling you people out there, I keep telling you, it's only a matter of time. I swear, if New World had come out, cooldowns? I mean, I know a lot of you people are just hoping that they're going to go with the no cooldowns, but the no cooldown version seems just as bad. 5-second debuff? It says, this test adds a global ramping AoE cost for each AoE cast. Similar to how Streak or Roll Dodge works, where you cast an AoE, you receive a debuff for 5 seconds. Each stack of the debuff increases the cost of any AoE cast. And I'm like, what about Mag Decay? Like, what about Mag Decay? Engulfing Flames, Talons, Inhale, what's it called? The Armor Buff, right? I mean, it's like almost every Mag Decay ability is an AoE. And it's not like Mag Decay has the greatest of regen as it is. Like, the costs are just shit. And then you're given more? What about Templars? Templars just spam jabs the whole time. This is like, what? I swear, man, y'all should just give it up. Like, ESO developers just like we calling it quits. We shutting down Cyrodiil. Enjoy your battlegrounds. And it's like, holy shit, man. It's like, this has been going on for years. Years of shitty performance. And their solution is they're adding cooldowns? I don't know, man. I do not know what ESO was thinking. And it's been years of bad performance. And it's literally going to come to the point where the developers are like, you can no longer cast abilities while in Cyrodiil. And then you'd be like, the lag is fixed, baby. And we ain't lagging anymore. I don't have to worry about my skills going off because I just can't cast anymore. And they'd be like, performance improved. And it's like, what? This just doesn't even make any sense why they would do this. I mean, I understand. They just literally just like, whatever the fuck they think is going to work, they're gonna like hope for. And it's like, what? I mean, damn. I mean, gone are the days of where the ESO server could hold, you know, roughly 2,000 people with very minimal lag. You know, gone are those days. It's like, now you got like 100 people on the server. I mean, shit. Summit lost his shit when he was out there and there was like barely anybody out there. He was in the no CP and he's like, what's up with my ping? I was like, why is the game lagging so badly? And then he just, I know for all y'all that were out there, that were like, Summit is playing. He's out here and he's going to make ESO great again. And then he was like, he just said, fuck this game, right? It was only a matter of time. It was only a matter of time before that man realized what many of us long-term players would be like, ESO, I don't know. I don't know about you. So now he's over there playing Guild Wars 2. And then he was just like, I ain't playing Guild Wars 2 anymore. Anyway. But this is a sad, sad state of ESO trying to add global cooldowns or individual AoE cooldowns. I mean, some classes more than others are going to be harshly affected by this. I mean, you don't have a lot of AoE abilities, like, for example, on Magicka Nightblade or Nightblade. But like on other classes, like, I mean, the main spammable on, if you think of things like Warden and Necromancer are AoEs. Like, you can look at Blast Bones and Shulks. Both of them are AoEs, and they already have like a mini cooldown because it takes 3 seconds for it to ramp up. But if you recast Shulks because maybe you messed up on your rotation, now it's going to cost you more. I mean, granted, stamina builds don't have as much of a problem when it costs to resource management. But Magicka DK, like a lot of their abilities, especially if you run like a Molten build. And you sitting there spamming, you know, engulfing multiple times, you're just eating extra costs. You know, volatile armor, it just doesn't make any sense. Or if you run talons, and it's like, what? That just doesn't even make any sense. That, I mean, you're trying to pull a Nightblade out, and now it's like you're using abilities that already cost too damn much as it is on shitty regen. You're trying to pull a Nightblade out of stealth and now you're getting penalized? That just doesn't even make any sense. This is a terrible change. This is a terrible change. But, it is what it is for all of you. I mean, it doesn't really matter. It's like, ESO is just like, for next patch, from what I'm reading, it's just like procs. It's just like procs on procs on procs. Like, you can literally run four different proc sets and you're good. Like, you don't even have to worry about casting, really casting abilities. You just need to have enough abilities to cast so that the procs go off. That's just a reality. I mean, shit, especially with some of these changes for next patch. And I'm just like, I don't know. I feel for you. Some people are out here making videos, skill cooldowns. The world is coming to an end. Unfortunately, this will probably get a positive performance result. Combat will slow down to a grinding halt. So performance will improve since people will be playing the game at a significantly slower speed. And that's just the reality. That's just what's going to happen. I am enjoying myself playing WoW. I went back to playing WoW. I'm playing retail. I'm getting ready for Shadowlands. If you do not know, of course, in WoW, they have an event 100% XP bonus till Shadowlands comes out, which is not till, I think, September or December. I forget. I think it's December. And I'm having a fucking good time. I'm waiting to get into some battlegrounds. I've seen open PvP. I thought they said there was no real open PvP in BFA. Apparently there was, because I was watching some the other day. I got some guy who came up out of nowhere, got ganked by a warrior. I was like, what the fuck is going on? I thought there was no open world. I was like, oh shit, I'm getting ready. So I'm rolling on a monk. I'm having a good time, man. I'm having a good time. If you haven't had the opportunity to come back, you're looking for some good content, I would say give BFA a try. Give WoW a try. Like, it doesn't take that long to get to endgame. The actual combat is pretty good, especially on retail. It's much more up to date. It's a lot faster than on classic. If you kind of like classic and you're looking for like more of that traditional open world, old school MMO, you have it right there in classic. Or if you want something that's a little more up to date, where it's a little more flashy, looks, you know, animations look a lot better, you've got retail. And then we got the coming expansion with Shadowlands. I would definitely give it a try. I'm looking forward to it. Like I said, I'm rolling a monk. I'm doing monk tanking for PvP, and then I'm monk tanking for PvE, and then I'm doing DPS monk for PvP, and then I'm going to be rolling also a Frost, what is it, Death Knight? Frost Death Knight. I'm looking forward to it. I'm having a good time. Waiting to get to some endgame content. Having a fun time tanking. Kind of like addicted to the combat and the gameplay. Wow, doing it right. I mean, literally, if New World had come out, I think most people who played ESO for PvP would have been like, yeah, no mas, I'm done. Like, we're going over here, right? ESO is lucky that New World went the route of PvE. If New World had not gone the route of PvE and had stuck to their original dream of making a solid PvP MMO, I think everybody, all these people who are out here giving ESO free advertising through streaming, at least from the PvP perspective, would have been like, we're going this way, man. We're going over here. No more skill delay. Like, literally all New World has to do is, I mean, the combat looks fairly similar to Dark Souls, a little bit faster. It looks very similar to ESO, and it's PvP, and it was PvP oriented. If it would have came out, I would have been like, I'm gone. I think most people are just sticking around. They're like, oh, I've been playing WoW for 15 years. And once you realize the sorry state that ESO PvP is in, you're like, damn, man, WoW ain't looking half bad now. I know I left. I'm sorry, baby. I'm coming back. There was something in everything. Right? That's just the reality. And I'm enjoying it. I would definitely give it a try. Now is a good time than ever because they got the 100% XP boost going on. They got a shit ton of classes. And it's not even just classes. You got different specs for all these different classes. So it's not even like you play one class and it's just like relegated to a specific role. You can go tank, you can go DPS, support, etc. Different types of DPS. I was surprised that they have so many different variations. I think it's like 32 different variations of gameplay that is offered within WoW. It's like, might as well. It's like, ain't nothing else out there. AOC, that's years away. New World, 6 to 9 months, at least 6 to 9 months. And it's like, what are you going to do? Are you going to be here? Like, counting the cooldown on your 5 seconds before you can recast your shulks or your engulfing flames? Hells no. It's not happening, man. I know I'm just saying, you know, sometimes you got to give up the ghost. And I think ESO's time has come.